गुड मॉर्निंग.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
दिस इज योर स्पीकिंग टेस्ट एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू आस्क यू सम क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग स्पीकिंग. एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम इंट्रोडक्शन क्वेश्चंस. मे आई नो योर फुल नेम प्लीज?
माय फुल नेम इज इंद्रजीत सिंह.
ओके इंद्रजीत, आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू सम इंट्रोडक्शन क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू जीन्स. डू यू वियर जीन्स?
Yes, I have many pair of jeans in my wardrobe because they are very durable. On the top of that, these don't easily get stretched out even though we wash these many times.
How often do you wear jeans?
I wear them on daily basis. I mean, I am a sick of formal attire like shirts or trousers that I have to wear in my workplace. That's why I always choose a pair of jeans and I mix it with a short sleeve t-shirt.
Do people in your country like wearing jeans?
Yes, the people in my country prefer to have jeans. These are the choice of clothing nowadays, and majority of the youth especially, they prefer to have jeans. Apparently, in the past two decades, people in my country loved wearing jeans, but nowadays bell-bottom jeans or flare jeans are on the trend.
Okay, in the trend. Next, we are going to talk about concentration. When do you need to focus?
At all times, I guess. I find it necessary to stay focused while driving, doing my work and so on. But I considered myself as an easily distracted individual. I mean, my mind often wanders while I am driving, making presentation or doing something repeatedly.
Do you find it difficult to concentrate sometimes?
Yeah, it happens. There are a variety of distractors around me. To be precise, for example, we have nowadays social networking sites. Besides, I also lose my concentration when I see there are people who are gossiping around me.
Then what do you like to do? You keep yourself concentrated.
I would say the best way to improve my concentration is by doing exercise. In fact, I have just participated in an activity for a few weeks which is being organized by one of the NGO here in Amritsar, and also one of my friends advised me to take up meditation. He told me that this also helped me to get more focus as from my work.
Okay, let's talk about swimming now. Why do many people like swimming?
Well, I think there are a few reasons. For one, it's a good way to beat the heat in the summer. Secondly, it is a good form of exercise as it involves all the muscles of our body. And lastly, it is simply a fun and a relaxing activity, and many improvements it can bring to our body.
Do you consider yourself as a good swimmer?
Not. In fact, I think I am in the learning mode, and in the coming days, I will be able to learn the swimming. Yeah.
What do you think are the benefits of swimming for individuals?
First and foremost, swimming is a tool which can save our life as well as the lives of others. Secondly, as I said before, it is a beneficial form of an exercise as it all uses all the muscle body parts. And lastly, swimming can be a form of therapy if you suffer from an injury, and all in all, it is a healthy and useful way to do something.
Is swimming popular in your country among all the people?
Not really. Surprisingly, there are a lot of people who don't know how to swim in the in my city, as it isn't very close to the coast. And I think it may be related to that. However, people who live along the coastal cities like Mumbai, Kolkata and Kerala, they know how to, swim.
Okay, Indrajit, this is the end of your speaking part one.
Jee.
Now we are moving towards speaking part two, that is cue card part.
Mm-hmm.
I will be giving you one cue card topic, and you would have complete 1 minute to prepare for that. You can make your own notes if you want, and then you have to speak for 2 minutes. Are you ready for that?
Right, yeah.
Okay, so your question is, describe a short journey that you dislike.
Mm.
Describe a short journey that you disliked. Your questions are, where you went, who you went with, what you did, and explain why you disliked this journey. Okay, you have complete 1 minute and your time starts now for preparation. Okay, in the race, you may start speaking now.
Okay. I recently had a journey. I wish I hadn't bothered with. I decided to do something in the city since currently I'm living in a remote area. But I had lent my car to a friend for a couple of days. So I thought it would be quite fun to hop on a bus for a change because it's something I haven't done for a long time. So I thought that I would set off early and get it done in a couple of hours and be back in time. The shopping wasn't anything urgent, it was just that I had some free time on that particular day, so I thought it would be nice to do something different. However, the journey did not go as planned. It was really hot day and when the bus finally arrived, I got on and it was clear that the air conditioner wasn't working. Moreover, the bus was packed with the people. So within minutes, I began to feel hot and sticky and extremely uncomfortable. But what happened next was even worse. After about 20 minutes of the traveling, the bus started to make some weird noises. The driver pulled over and told us that there was a problem and we couldn't continue. We had to wait for the second bus. The second bus already had some passengers when it arrived. And with all of us from the first bus as well, there we have to just up a small room and we have to stand and manage there. The whole experience was rapidly turning into something I was beginning to seriously regret in my life. What had started out as something very funny and different was quickly becoming one of the worst trips I ever had. Eventually, we arrived in the city and I wasn't really in the mood of shopping. So I stopped at a cafe to drink and relax for a moment. It really has to be one of the worst trips I have ever made on a bus. And now I wish I had just waited until I had my car back. It would have been so much easier for me. That's all.
Okay.
I have to do. Yeah.
Okay, that is. That is up for part two. Now we are moving towards the part three. That would be the follow-up question. And your first question is, what mode of travel do you consider the safest one?
I would say I considered traveling by car to be the safest, but because of the increasing traffic and road accidents, I now consider train journey as the safest mode. Whenever I have to travel long in distances, I travel by a train. And I also consider air journeys to be safe, but recently I have seen in news one crash. So it had made me less sure whether it is safe or not.
Okay. Do people in your country also like to prefer the same kind of traveling mode?
I don't think so. People in my country prefer different kind of modes to travel. Majority of the people prefer to travel by train since it is economical way to commute from one place to another.
Okay. How can traveling be useful for people?
Traveling is useful in many ways. First, it's one of the best ways to meet new people and make friends. Secondly, it enables us to learn about new cultures and traditions. Traveling also, in a way, breaks monotony of everyday life. There is something very enjoyable to plan a holiday and visiting other places.
Do you think that people can learn many different things by traveling as well?
Yes, I believe people can learn a lot from the society. a person who widely travels comes into contact with many people and he gets new version of life. His outlook about life gets broadened and widened. He comes to understand the viewpoints of different people and different places, and he has become more self-controlled, I think.
Okay, have the transportation methods these days changed from the past?
Yes, of course, ma'am. Nowadays, we have seen there are many changes happening in the transportation methods. With the increasing income of the people, nowadays people are traveling by air as well. In the past days, most of the people try to travel by a train or car.
Okay, where in your opinion should people visit during the vacation?
I have thought about it a lot. I think people should take vacations at a place which is different from their own native place. Let me give you an example. For example, I'm living in a plain, so I love to travel to the hills and mountains, and people who live in continental locations can visit beaches. So ultimately though, it all depends upon the people's choices.
Okay, in what ways, according to you, can society benefit from regular traveling?
I believe there are several ways a society can benefit from a regular traveler. Firstly, regular travelers can make society more open-minded by spreading the knowledge of different places and cultures. And moreover, sometimes when these travelers like something about other cultures, they might bring it into their own culture as well.
Okay, are there any disadvantages as well of traveling?
Sorry, ma'am?
Are there any disadvantages of traveling as well?
Yes, I think there are many disadvantages, because whenever we travel, we feel uncomfortable if the journey is very long. One of my sister has went to Canada, and when she reached there, she told me, like, in the flight, to face the problem of leg space, and so I think that would be the case. And moreover, there are many people who do not take care of the place they are visiting to, so they, you know, spread the waste here and there. So these kind of things, I think, is going to create problems and consideration and the point to consider when we are going to travel anywhere.
Okay, Indrajit, this is up for your speaking skills. Okay, it was nice talking to you in the day.
Yeah,
have a good day.
Thank you.